Apparently, Newbee has been banned by CDA. CDA is like the Chinese league organization that looks over the tournaments, the teams, and things like that. And apparently, they have match fix. This is the original article. It's in Chinese here. Match fixing means that somewhere these guys, Newbee as an organization and the players together, have bet on themselves to lose a game. This is a problem that's been running in Dota 2 and other esports games, and even in like real sports for a very long time. And one of the reasons being is like you can get a lot of money from this. You know, you got like these millionaire guys who come to you, you're like, yo, you throw this game, we're gonna give you this much money, you know, whatever percentage that may be, and then it's like a sure win kind of thing, right? You know, sometimes gambling can go really far, and most of the time, you know, people tell you to stay away from that stuff. You know, if you're just doing it for fun and it's regulated and you know your limits, it's okay. But when you take it this far, you are breaking the competitive integrity, you're bringing a bad name to, you know, the game, you're bringing a bad name to your organization, even the people you know, because this is gonna haunt them. And one thing to note why this is so big is because it's Newbee, right? Newbee is a team that won TI, this org won TI back at TI4, got second place at TI7, right, when they lost to Liquid. So you can see here, like their recent results, they even sponsored the American team that was at last TI. They won a ESO1 Genting, another major at Perfect World Masters. Like, it's crazy, right? This org has been extremely successful. And on top of that, the people that have been banned due to this match mixing is Moogy, Wizard, Weishi, AQ, and Faith. Now, Moogy was part of that TI7 team who got second place, and Faith actually is a TI champion from TI2, right, when he was playing in IG, which is ridiculous because I've known Faith forever, and this guy, like, he's a beast, he played so well. I know the last years have not been so kind to him, but at the end of the day, like, I can't believe that they would actually do this. Now, Newbee are planning to appeal this situation, and we will hear more from it, but, you know, be able to just say this and put Newbee in the spotlight like this, it means they must be so sure that this actually happened. We will hear more from it the upcoming days, that's for sure, but this is going to shake the entire Dota world, especially because they're going to look at match fixing, you know, this kind of things that shouldn't be happening more closely, especially, like, I've heard some rumors and a lot of people have always speculated that, especially in the tier 2, tier 3 scene, this happens quite a lot, especially in those scenes where people don't have a lot of money or they're not getting paid a lot, but they've invested a lot of time into the game. But, you know, when people like this who are literally, you know, in their country, some of the millionaires and such are willing to do it because, like, you have to understand, you have to think, like, how much are they actually getting from doing this, right? The money had to be worth it. Like, you know what they say, right? Everybody has a price. These Newbee guys, like, they got their price, apparently. If they actually did do it, they got their price, and it must have been a lot of money, because I can't imagine, especially somebody like Faith, who I've known for so long, to, you know, stoop this low to do something so ridiculous as match fix. And now they have a lifetime ban in this league. Now, this means that it's not going to be a lifetime ban in China only. There's very likely that in the next couple of days, you know, someone like Valve or other tournament organizers will also be getting involved and being like, yo, we're going to adopt this ban, especially if it comes to light that it's, you know, 1000% true. Right now, all we know is that CDA, Imba Media, like, they did their research. They found out about what happened, and now they've decided to get rid of them. And it's ridiculous. It's like, just to think something like this is even possible for... I'm just so baffled. Like, I just can't understand it. It just hurts. And it really does. The CDA Alliance, the CDA... Yeah, so here's the English translation of the post that they made. We'll post it in the description so you guys can check that out as well. But yeah, hopefully in the upcoming days, I'm still praying that this is not true. I'm praying that Faith, especially, like, his name will be cleared. Moogy, you know, a freaking runner-up at TI. This man played like a beast. I know these guys make good money, and I really hope that it wasn't because of money, and maybe it'll come to light the real story, what happened. who knows, maybe they were threatened, you know, there's a lot of stuff that's possible, especially when shady stuff went down. There was a lot of talk about NEWBEE, how they were involved in some money problems, and they were borrowing money from other organizations, other, you know, millionaires and stuff. And I know that the founder of NEWBEE, like, he's got a bit, but we'll see what happens with that. I'm not too sure of the information there. I haven't really looked into, you know, the background of NEWBEE that much, but just from the Dota 2 side of things, this is absolutely nuts.